Yeah, myself is a Pawan. Today I am going to teach you so energy level diagram of diatomic molecules. Energy level diagram. Diatomic molecules. So here. So these diatomic molecules, energy level diagram of diatomic molecules. So based on quantum mechanics, we are going to represent. So here basically the linear combination of atomic are based on. So here the linear combination of atomic orbitals. So the linear combination of atomic orbital. So is nothing but this is always based on what it is a quantum mechanics. It explains the quantum mechanics. Based on this quantum mechanics, we are going to represent. So here the wave motion, wave symbols. So here the first one is, so here in this case, so we are going to take two molecules. One is a 1,3,1,3 butadiene structure and benzene structure. So if you go for the structure of 1,3 butadiene, so here the 1, butadiene is, so here the structure is like this. Here the hydrogen, here the hydrogen. Here the hydrogen, here also one hydrogen, so here also one hydrogen. This is the, so 1,3 butadiene structure, 1,3 butadiene structure. It is a butadiene structure. So if you see this 1,3 butadiene structure, there is a two conjugated ethane molecules. Here the one conjugated molecule, here the another conjugated ethane molecules. So here the total number of pi bonds is there. The number of electrons, pi electrons is 4 electron is there. So these 4 electron we are going to take p orbitals. If you take the energy level of diagram atomic molecules, so this is that. So here we are going to do this 1,3 butadiene later. First we will go for the how the diatomic molecule will take place, nitrogen, how the oxygen and fluorine. So today I am going to teach you the nitrogen, oxygen, so fluorine we will see later. So if you take this nitrogen, so here the nitrogen means how many total number of electrons it should be present. So total 14 electrons it should be present. So here in this case, according to the MOT, molecular orbital theory electronic configurations. So if you see these configurations, so there are 4 configuration is there. If you see this. So less than of 14 electrons, less than of 14 electron, one configuration is there. That configuration is sigma 1s or sigma 1s star and sigma 2s or sigma 2s star and next. So here the pi 2py and pi 2p. So here the x we are going to take and y and next sigma 2pz. So next one is what? Sigma 2p. Z star and next pi 2p y star and next pi 2p. So here the x, this is a x pi 2p x and 2p y. So these are all bonding and antibonding. And next, if electrons can be arranged more than of 14 electron, so another combination is there, that is 1s and sigma 1s star and sigma 2s and sigma 2s star. And next one is, so here the sigma 2pz and next, so here the pi 2p, 2p y, pi 2p x will be there, y. And next one is, so here the pi, so 2p x and pi 2p y, these are all antibonding, so we can mark it as a star mark. And next sigma 2p z star, these are the combination. So now we are going to take nitrogen. So if you take the nitrogen, so there are two atoms will be there. If you see this energy level diagram, so this is the energy level diagram. So here we are going to take first electronic configuration. If you see this, there are two nitrogens will be there. Here one nitrogen. So we are going to take another nitrogen. So the electronic configuration of nitrogen is 1s2, 2s2. So here the number is 7. So here the 2p, 3 will be there. So this is the electronic configuration of each nitrogen. So now I am going to draw. So here this is a 1, so here this is a 1, electron. This is 1s of nitrogen, the another 1s of nitrogen, and next, so another, so here this is a 2s. So this is a 2s of one nitrogen and 2s of another nitrogen. Next one is what? How many is the p orbital? 3 p orbital. So we need to take 3 p orbitals, and next, so here this one is 1, this one is, we are going to take 2, 1 or 2. So here there are 3 p orbitals, it should be there. So if you see this, so 2p3 is here also 2p3 is here. So first you can fill the 1s. So how many electrons it can be accommodate each nitrogen? 2. So one nitrogen is here, the other nitrogen. Here also 1s2, one nitrogen, 2 electrons. Here also 2s2 is there, here also 2s2 is there. So you can take one electron is here, the other electron. One electron is here, the other electron. You can combine. So here this, whatever the below one is there, this is bonding molecular orbital. This is antibonding molecular orbital. Same for here also. So here, this is also bonding molecular orbital, this is also antibonding molecular orbital. So here I am writing here also bonding molecular orbital, here antibonding molecular orbital. So here total is 2 electrons is here also 2 electrons. So total it become as a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here also 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here the 3p3 is there. So each orbital will accommodate only one electron. So like this, here also one electron. So here it totally become as what? It is a, so this energy, this level is called a lower energy level. So it can be represent, so 2px or 2py, and next one is what? 2pz. So here also sigma 2p. So here the pi 2pz, here also pi 2pz. So here the pi 2pz, here is sigma 2px, and here also sigma 2py. So here how many electrons is here total? 6 electrons. First fill the lower energy level, 1, 2, 3, then the pairing will take place, 4, 5, 6. Now this is a filling of the electrons according to the molecular orbitals. Now you are going to calculate bond order. What is the formula of bond order? Bond order of is equal to, so here the NB minus, so here the NA. What is the NB is here? Bonding electrons. You can count it, whatever here it is a bond molecular orbital, you can count it. So here the 2, so here also 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So here the half, so 10 electrons, antibonding molecular orbitals, means upper one antibonding. This entire thing is what? It is a antibonding, so antibonding molecular orbital. So here this entire thing is considered as an antibonding molecular. So here also the higher energy level, always you remember that bonding molecular orbital will comes under lower energy level. The higher energy level always it occupies the antibonding molecular orbital. So now we can count it, antibonding molecular orbitals, here the 2 electrons, here the 2 electron, total it become as a 4 electron. Here there is no electron will be accommodated in the antibonding. So here therefore the half that equal to 6, so it become as a 3, means so nitrogen, so each nitrogen, so here it can be have of what, 3 is a bond order. So in between the 2 nitrogen the bond can be exist as a 3. That is what it is a, so bond order calculation in case of the nitrogen. If you take oxygen, so here the oxygen is what, it is a O2, right? So here in this, so oxygen 8, so your electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p, so here the 4, right? So here we are going to take 2 oxygen, here one oxygen, here also another oxygen. If you take, so here this is, here this is a 1s, this is also 1s. Again you can take one more 2s, so here, here 2s, this is a 2s, this is 2s, 2 oxygen, each oxygen you have to write the electronic configuration. Next 3p, so here the p also we can take 1, 2, 3 and next, so here we are going to take 2 electrons and next 1, so here the 1, here the 2. So total it become as, so here also it become as 3, 1, 2, 3. So here now you can check it, so 1s2, 1s2 is there, here also 1s2, 2 electrons here, here also 2 electrons, here also 2 electrons, 2 electron, 2 electron, 2 electron. This will comes under bonding molecular orbital, this also comes under bonding molecular orbital. The above one is what? It is a antibonding. This is antibonding molecular orbital. This entire area is also antibonding molecular orbital. Now you check it. So these 2 electrons, these 2 electrons, it become as what? 4 electron. Here also 4 electron. Now it is also 4 electron. Here also 4 electron. 2p4. So each orbital you can fill with 1 electron. 1, 2, 3, and next 4. Here also, I think it is not clear. So here 1, 2. So we can take it here. This area I am taking is here. This area is connected is here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So total become as 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then it will enter into the 7, 8. Right? So here this is what this complete area is called as what? It is a 2px, 2py. This is antibonding. This is antibonding bonding molecular orbital. This is called as what? Antibonding molecular orbital. Now you check it. What is a bond order? So bond order is equal to half NB minus NA. What is the NB is here? Total number of bonding electrons. So whatever the lower energy level is there, that we are going to take 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you can take 1 half. So here the 10 minus antibonding molecular orbital 2, 4, 5, 6. So you are going to take. So therefore that half is that equal to, so for the total is it become as a 2. Therefore the oxygen in between these 2 oxygen, it will be exist only double bond. So here this is what it is, a diatomic molecule. If you see this diatomic molecule, this nitrogen is also diatomic molecule, this oxygen is also diatomic molecule, so here the fluorine is also diatomic orbital. So if you see this one, so in this all the electronic configuration, we are going to explain magnetic property. So what is a magnetic property? So if any orbital will have the single electron or unpaired electron, then that is called as what? Paramagnetic. If here, if you see this, if you observe all this, all are paired electrons. So therefore, the oxygen, nitrogen will have of what? Diamagnetic in nature, diamagnetic in nature. If you see this oxygen, so here this is 2, here 2, here 2, here 2, here 2, here 2. But here one electron, single electrons is possible. Means 2 unpaired electrons are there. Therefore, the magnetic power of, the magnetic nature, the magnetic property, or magnetic nature of oxygen is paramagnetic in nature. Because, so this oxygen will have the 2 unpaired electrons. It is 2 unpaired electron, that's the reason. So here this magnetic property of the oxygen is, so it is a paramagnetic in nature. In case of this nitrogen, here there is no orbital, here any so here all orbitals are paired electrons will be there. So here the oxygen nitrogen will have the diamagnetic in nature. Thank you all.